Hey everybody, excuse me, doing a bit of an impromptu stream tonight. I've been super busy this last week, and I'm going to be super busy next week, so I figured I would just hop on and do something while I can. So lately I've been kind of on a Dungeons & Dragons kick, specifically one random demon called the Glabrezu. So tonight I'm basically just going to be sketching a Glabrezu demon that's kind of themed after the demon prince Graz'zt. So I'm just reading this kind of from his description from a book. So Graz'zt is a creature of debauchery and desire who strives to accumulate more power, delights in ostentatious finery and pageantry, sating his decadent desires with subjects and consorts alike. He particularly relishes the spectacle of self-indulgent person's life collapsing into ruin. So that's the demon prince, and the kind of demon we're kind of theming after him, it would be like his servant or something, is a Glabrezu, and they're like these weird demons with like dog faces and crab arms and like an extra set of little arms on their stomach. So we're going to kind of like work within that framework, but try to make it look like it would be kind of the same stuff as Graz'zt, or kind of a servant of Graz'zt. So that's the goal. That's what we're going to try to accomplish tonight. So first, I'm just trying to think of like the overall shape. I did kind of one of these before, which is the same type of demon, but more kind of patterned after Orcus, like the demon prince of like the undead. So that one was kind of hunched over and decrepit looking, but since this one is a servant of Graz'zt, I kind of wanted it to be a little bit more like kind of a power posey type thing. Like more like arrogant and sort of prideful stance. So I'm just kind of playing around sketching, trying to get something that looks So for these crab claws, we're pulling pretty heavily from like box crabs, which just look kind of cool. Their claws are very broad and flat and kind of fold up, kind of like a box around them. Kind of moving the leg around a little bit. It's a little more dynamic pose. At this point, we're mostly just blocking things out and kind of getting an idea of what proportions we're going to have. And the general kind of shapes of things. Actually, I kind of want to move this head down so it's like more kind of hidden behind the claws. And I think the lower body is just like way too long now. Okay, so this is kind of a mess, but I think it's kind of close enough to where we can start painting. I tend to not do a lot of elaborate line work just because it's super tedious. So I'm trying to think of a good kind of base color, and I'm thinking maybe like a mid-range purple would work. Say, let's try a little darker and a little less saturated. Kind of go from there. Alright, and now we're gonna add a little bit more local color. So, I'm kind of thinking like maybe the crab parts kind of fade a little bit. I'm actually going to go a little bit bluer on the skin tones. And this, I'm thinking, will eventually be like gold-ish colored, but of course, a lot of little eyes in there. I think that's a good kind of, I guess, starting place. Go ahead and group those together. Now hide the background. Control A, Control Shift C. And I'm basically just making a copy of everything I've done that's all on one layer, so I can edit from this point forward. I'd still go back and find like the original sketch and everything if I want to later. Rather than just kind of collapsing everything down. Next, I'm going to add some like really strong highlights. Just to kind of be able to see things a little bit better here. All right, so let's try to get this face looking a little bit more dog-like. We're gonna hide like half of it, so it probably won't be super obvious no matter what we do. But we can get some more kind of wolf-like shapes going on. Ooh, excuse me. Alright, I'm gonna change up these eyes a little bit. Because I feel like they're looking up. And I'm just gonna make them look down, because these guys are supposed to be like super tall. Looks a little crazy right there. Throw on some kind of body jewelry. Okay, now I have to figure out how these, like, stomach arms are attached. Guess we just have another, like, smaller set of abs. Or, sorry, smaller set of pecs where the abs should be. I guess we'll just kind of add some abs in down here. Kind of clean that up. That's kind of a messy area. But we'll come back to it later. All right. I'm actually going to move this into Sketchbook Pro really quick. So I'm just going to throw out my pre-stream graphic while I switch programs. So just bear with me for just a second. Gonna turn off the background layer just so I can I can actually see where my canvas is. Okay. So I mostly brought this in so I could get this sword straight. Because it is kind of bowed. So. Just gonna get that straightened out. Top straightened out here. All Okay. All right, so that I was just kind of adding a little bit more color variance because it was very kind of just two-toned, like kind of gold and purple. So I just wanted to add a little bit more color. So I just added some blue into the claws there. I'm going to bounce back to Photoshop now. I was mostly just straightening some things up. I could have probably just done that in Photoshop, but hold up. So back in Photoshop, so now I'm going to go in and try to kind of detail the musculature a little bit, and kind of I'm thinking that the skin is like really dark, like a kind of blackish purple color, which is kind of like the color of Graz'zt's skin in most depictions. So we kind of that's kind of the basis for our color scheme, is we're doing something a little bit kind of similar to Graz'zt. as far as color scheme goes. But we also want to be able to, like, see stuff. So, and that's always really hard, kind of. Making dark. Like, unnatural skin tones and, getting them to read really well. think we'll go back to a wider stance. That looks less good now that I've had some time to think about it. Right. I think overall, like, the head is too big, so I'm just gonna shrink that down. The liquefy tool. Also kind of shrinking the claws a little bit. Gonna kind of nudge a few other things around. Alright, you kind of see the difference there. I'm also gonna exaggerate these horns a little bit, and maybe we'll make them like kind of multi-pronged. So that was just kind of giving it a bit of a carapace, kind of like a crab, and kind of having some of those kind of lighter blues kind of bleed into the musculature a little bit. And that kind of gives us some colors to kind of make more definition in the chest here. All right, so I guess we gotta figure out what we're gonna do with these feet down here. So. I'm thinking either like dog feet or like hooves that kind of mirror the carapace up top. You know, I've talked myself into that. We're gonna do that. So do some broad kind of flat.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right. I'm going to go ahead and end it there. So there we have a Glabrezu, servant of Graz'zt, from Dungeons & Dragons. Thanks for watching. I could spend more time on this and kind of like detail out more of the textures and things. And I might at some point do that. But I think this is kind of enough to kind of give you an idea of what we're going for. So thanks for watching. If you want to see more of my work, you can check it out over on Facebook and Instagram at Anthony James Rich Art. If you want to help support me, and streams like this, you can, you know, give me money over at patreon.com/AnthonyJamesRich. My streaming schedule is a little bit up in the air for the foreseeable future. I just kind of got a new day job, so getting kind of situated with that is kind of messing up my schedule quite a bit. So hopefully I can get something together in the next few weeks. But until then, I guess I'll just be streaming whenever. So again, thanks for watching and have a great week.